Hello student, my name is Ritesh Yadav. I am assistant professor in department of electrical and electronics engineering. So in this lecture I will discuss Thevenin's theorem. Okay, so these are the topics in the unit number 2. Okay, so you can see Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, superposition theorem, maximum power transfer theorem, reciprocity theorem, compensation theorem, Telegen theorem. Okay, so these are the theorems for AC network, and the same theorem you can apply for the DC network. Okay, so today I will discuss Thevenin's theorem. So what is the statement, and we will see numerical problems for the AC network consisting only independent voltage or current source. Then we will see numerical problems for AC network consisting independent and dependent voltage and current source. Okay, so first we will see a statement. So what is the statement for the Thevenin's theorem? A linear, active and RLC network which contains one and more independent or dependent voltage or current source can be replaced by a single voltage source, that is VTS, in series with an equivalent impedance, that is ZTS. So what is VTS? VTS represents the open circuit voltage across two terminals of the network. Then what is ZTS? So this ZTS represents the equivalent impedance between two terminal when all the independent voltage source or current source are replaced by their internal resistance. So here you can see voltage source are replaced by short circuit, and independent current source are replaced by open circuit. If any circuit consists dependent voltage or current source, in that case all dependent voltage source and current source remain in the circuit as they are. Therefore, these sources are neither short circuited nor open circuited. So this is important point. Okay, so this is the network. So this is the linear active RLC network. Okay, so you can replace this network into the Thevenin's equivalent model. So this is the Thevenin's equivalent model. So in this equivalent circuit you can see VTH, this is the single voltage source in series with ZTH. Okay, now you can see some important point. So this Thevenin's theorem is always valid irrespective of type of network and type of voltage and current source. Then this Thevenin's theorem is not applicable to the network containing non-linear element, and the second point is unilateral element such as PN junction diode. So let's see example number 1. So in the network as shown in below figure, just find out the current through load ZL by using Thevenin's theorem. So what is the value of Z1, Z2, Z3 and ZL? So here you can see Z1 is equal to 8 plus Z8, Z2 is equal to 8 minus Z8, and Z3 is 2 plus Z2, and ZL value is minus J10 ohm. Okay, so first what you have to do, first remove this load ZL from the circuit. So this circuit will be like this. This is voltage source. Suppose this is terminal A and this is terminal B. This is Z1, this is Z2, so Z3 and this is Z2. And this is the supply voltage 10 at angle 0. So when you are converting this circuit into the Thevenin's equivalent model, So first you have to remove this ZL through which you have to calculate the current. Okay, then find out the ZTH and VTH across terminal AB. Okay, so first find out the VTH. Okay, so here you can see this terminal A and B is open circuited, so no current will flow through this Z3 impedance. So the voltage drop across this impedance will be zero. So this VTH will appear across this impedance. So voltage drop across this impedance will give the value of ZTH. So find out the current value here and multiply this current value with this impedance, you will get the VTH. So first find out the current through impedance Z2. So what will be the value of I? So I is nothing but V divided by Z1 plus Z2. So V is 10 at angle 0 and Z1 is 8 plus J8 and Z2 is 8 minus J8. So this will cancel out. So 10 divided by 16. So you will get 5 divided by 8 at angle 0. Okay. So this is the value of I. Now multiply this I value with Z2. You will get VTS. So I into Z2. I is 5 by 8 at angle 0 and Z2 is 8 minus J8. This will cancel out. So 5, 1 minus J1. So when you will calculate, here you can see this is the value of I, 0.625 at angle 0. When you will calculate this value 5 by 8, you will get 0.625. Then when you will calculate this value, you will get 7.07 at angle minus 45 degree. So this is the value of VTS. Now calculate ZTH. Okay, so when you are calculating the ZTH, in that case you have to replace the independent voltage source by the open circuit and independent current source by when you are calculating the ZTH, you have to replace this independent voltage source by the short circuit, and if any current source is present, then you have to replace that current source by open circuit. Okay, so this is the voltage source, so you have to replace this voltage source by the short circuit, and this is the value of Z1, this is Z3 and this is Z2. Now here you have to find out ZTH. So you know this Z1 and Z2 are in parallel, so Z1 is parallel with Z2, then this combination will come in series with Z3. So this will give value of ZTH. ZTH is equal to, you know, Z1 value 8 plus J8, and what is the value of Z2? 8 minus J8 plus Z3. So what is the value of Z3? 2 plus J20. 2 plus J20. Now solve this. So 8 plus J8, 8 minus J8 divided by 8 plus J8 plus 8 minus J8 plus 2 plus J20. Okay, so this will cancel out. So just multiply this. So you'll get 64 minus J64 plus J64, then plus 64 divided by 16. You just add this to 8 plus 8, 16 plus 2 plus J20. So here this minus J64 and plus J64 will cancel out. So here you get 2 into 64 divided by 16 plus 2 plus J20. Okay, now solve this. So this will be 4 and this will be 8. 8 plus 2, 10. So it will be 10 plus J20. So this is the value of ZTH. Okay, now you can see ZTH value is 20 plus J20 ohm. Okay, now you find out the value of IL. So what will be the value of IL? So IL is nothing but VTH divided by ZTH plus ZL. Okay. So what is the value of VTH? 7.07 at angle minus 45, or you can write 5 minus J5. Whatever you want to write, you can write. So I am writing 5 minus J5 divided by, what is the value of ZTH? So ZTH value is 10 plus J20. And what is the value of ZL, load value, minus J10. So after solving this equation, you will get IL value. So what is the value of IL? You can see minus J by 2, or you can write 0.5 at angle minus 90 degree. Okay, so this way you can find out the current through load resistance by using Thevenin's theorem. Okay. Let's see another example. So this is example number 2. Find the Thevenin's equivalent network of the circuit shown across terminal XY. XY you can see, this one X and this one Y. Then find the current through 1 ohm resistor. So here you have to find the current I. Suppose this 1 ohm resistance is the load resistance RL. Okay. So what is the first step? First, you have to remove this load resistance RL. So this circuit you will get after removing the load resistance RL. Then find out the VTH and ZTH. Remember one thing, whenever this dependent voltage or current source is present in the circuit, in that case, first you have to find out the VTH. Then find out the ISC current. ISC current is the short circuit current through terminal XY. Okay. Then find the ZTH. What is the ZTH? ZTH is nothing but open circuit voltage divided by short circuit current. Okay. So first find out the current I, then calculate the ZTH. Because you are calculating the ZTH across this terminal XY. So this is the VTH, or you can say open circuit voltage. So the same voltage will appear across this point. Okay. So once you will calculate this current I, you will get the value of VTH. Okay. Now apply the KVL in the circuit, and this I current is flowing through this path. Okay, so this value will be, suppose this is VTS, so this will be plus, this will be minus, this will be plus, this will be minus, and this will be plus, this will be minus, this will be plus, this will be minus. Okay. So assume this is Z1 impedance and this is Z2 impedance. Okay. So Z1 is 1 plus J2, that is ohm, and Z2 is 2 plus J4 ohm. Now apply the KVL. So you will get plus 50 minus 2 plus, then minus 2 plus 2i, then go to minus 2 plus, or you can take plus plus 2 minus. So minus, take impedance Z2, so this is the Z2 and this is Z1. So Z2 2 plus J4 into I minus 1 plus J4 into I, that is equal to 0. Okay, now you can see 50 plus 2i minus 2i minus J4i, you just multiply these two term, minus I minus J2, that is equal to 0. So this 2i, 2i will cancel out. So just take I common and rearrange the term. So you will get 50 divided by 1 plus J6. After solving this equation, you will get I value. So what is the value of I? This one, 8.2199 at angle of minus 80.5376. So this way you can calculate this value I. Now multiply this current value with this Z1 impedance, you will get the value of VTH after subtracting from this value. Okay, so this is plus, this is minus, this is VTH. Now apply the KVL again. So plus VTH minus 50 at angle 0. Okay, now here you can see current is flowing in this direction, so this will be plus and this will be minus because this is Z1. So plus 1 plus J2, multiply this value with current I, that is equal to 0. Now VTH is equal to 50 at angle 0 minus 1 plus J2. What is the value of I? You can see here 8.2199 at angle of minus 80.5376, minus 80.5376. Okay, so after solving this equation, you will get VTH value. So what is the value of VTH? 32.88 at angle 9.47. So this is the value of VTH. Okay, now calculate the short circuit current ISC. So first you have to short circuit this terminal X and Y, and this is the ISC current. Okay, now rearrange this circuit in this form, because these two points are short circuit. Then apply the KVL in this loop and in this loop. First apply the KVL in this loop. So this is the Z1 and this is positive polarity, this is the negative polarity. So minus current I, Z1 value is 1 plus J2 ohm plus 50 at angle 0, that is equal to 0. So you will get the value of I. I is nothing but 50 at angle 0 divided by 1 plus J2. So what is the value of I? 22.36 at angle of minus 63.43. Okay. Then calculate this current ISC. So for this you have to again apply the KVL in this loop. Okay. Now apply the KVL. So you will get plus 2i. You are going minus 2 plus. Then the current is flowing in this direction. So this will be plus, this will be minus. Okay. And one more thing, this ISC current is flowing through this circuit. Okay, and this I current. So just apply the KCL at this point. Apply the KCL at this point. So you will get I minus ISC through this path. Now apply the KVL. Plus 2I, then minus I minus ISC. What is the value of Z? 2 plus J4, that is equal to 0. So you, here you can write 2i minus, just multiply this two terms. So I 2 plus J4, then minus minus plus ISC 2 plus J4, that is equal to 0. So here you can write 2i minus 2i minus J4i. Just multiply this I with this term, then 4ISC 2 plus J4, that is equal to 0. So this will cancel out. Now arrange this term. So here you will get ISC, that is equal to J4 into I divided by 2 plus J4. Okay, this will be ISC only. Now multiply this current value with this term. So what is the value of I? 22.36 at angle minus 63.43. So just multiply. So ISC is nothing but J4 at angle of 22.63, I think. Sorry, 36. At angle of 63.36. Minus sign will be here. Minus 63.43. Okay. Divide by 2 plus J4. So after solving this equation, you will get the ISC value. This one. 20 at angle minus 36.86. Now you have ZTH value, you have ISC value. So you can find out ZTH. What is ZTH? VOC by ISC, or you can write VTH by ISC. So ZTH nothing but VOC by ISC. VOC or VTH, both are same. So what is the value of VOC? VTH VOC value is 32.88 at angle of 9.47. Thirty two point 32.88 at angle of 9.47 divided by ISC. So what is the value of ISC? 20 at angle of minus 36.86. Okay. So after solving this, you will get ZTH value. So what is the value of ZTH? 1.64 at angle of 46.33. At angle of 46.33. So what will be the equivalent circuit? This is ZTH and this is VTS. Now connect the load here through which you are calculating the current I. This is 1 ohm resistance. Now current I is equal to, so IL suppose, VTH divided by ZTH plus ZL. So what is the value of VTH? 32.88 at angle 9.47 degree. And what is the value of ZTH? 1.64 at angle 46.33 plus 1. After solving this equation, you will get the value of IL. So what is the value of IL? 13.4546 at angle minus 19.643. This value. So this is the current IL through load resistance R. So this way you can find out the current by using Thevenin's theorem. So this is all about for the today's lecture. Thank you.